and a woman having an issue of blood of 12 years. Luke chapter 8, verse 43. An issue of blood for 12 years. Dear child of God, what is that issue in your life? What is that challenge in your life? What is that circumstances in your life? What is that situation in your life that has turned you totally off? What is that situation in your life that has turned your world upside down? What is that situation in your life that has made your heart very sore? The Word of God made us to know that this woman was having an issue of blood for 12 years. And not just some issues that she can manage. The Word of God says, which had spent all her living upon, which she had spent every single thing she had. She had spent all. Neither could be healed of any. What happens at that time in your life when everything you thought would be a remedy to your situation hasn't helped you? The Word of God says she suffered in the hands of the physicians. I mean, everything that you were trying to see would be the way out had rather been a pain. Everything you thought would be your way out of the issue, everything you thought would be your place of safe haven had been rather a devastation. Yet, the Word of God said, came behind him and touched the border of his garment. She pressed on to God. When you are having that issues, what do you do? She went beyond the press and she needed to touch the hem of the garment of the Lord. She needed to touch the border of his garment. She needed to go to that one that has the power to change a situation. She needed to go to that one that has the power to change everything she has been in. Dear child of God, there is a time when the situation of your life has grown and become very matured. I mean, imagine a child that was born from the day she had this issue. Imagine the situation that she was in. She had offensive other people did not want to come close to her. But she said, I know who to go to. Everybody may be running away from me. Everything about my life may seem already very appalling to so many people. Everything around my life may already look like things that people do not want to associate with. But I know the one person I would associate with that would turn everything about my life around. And the Bible says she went in the press. She went to the Lord. She went so further to the place that the Lord is. And she was made whole. What happens when those issues of your life are coming so heavy upon you? What happens when those issues have lingered for so long a time and it has already made you to become very ashamed? What happens when the issues of your life have placed a particular stench upon your life? What happens when people are avoiding you? What happens when people are talking about you? What happens when you go along the street and you see that the nose are wagging? People are gossiping about you. People are gossiping about your situation. People are saying, when will she get married? People are saying, when will she finally be reunited with her husband? People are saying, when will she finally get a child? People are saying, when will she get a job and leave this place? People are saying, when would he get married? People are saying, when would he have everything working for him? People are saying, when would he ever get to be with his family again? Are you in that phase of your life that the issues that you are having are causing the people around to push you away? The people around to stop you? The people around you are already the issues you are having even more. The people around you are hindering you from receiving your blessings. The people around you are standing in the way because they were the press. There were a lot of people. A lot of people stood in their way. A lot of people stood in our way. but she would not relent. When you know that a lot of things are standing before you, you have tried to go to the right, you have tried to go to the left, but everything seemed to have wedged you in. You have tried to do everything you can do. Do you give up at that point? The word of God says she pressed on until the point that she touched the hem of his garment. Dear child of God, there is something that you need to do. You need to press on. You need to make up your mind that whatever it takes, I will get through this one. Like David, who said, "My soul followeth hard after you." It was difficult, but he said, "I will keep following." When David made those words known, he said, "I will follow hard after you." It was in the cave. It was at that point when he was chased back and forth. It was at that point when his life was in danger. But he said, "I will follow hard after you." You know what it means? That his life was at stake, but he would not fail to give God his due sacrifice of worship. He knew that his life was literally in his hands. He knew that he could not count for the next minute of his life. He knew he could not even trust what is going to happen within the next moment. But yet he said, "I will follow hard after you. No matter the situation, you will still be my God." When those problems, when those challenges you are facing, when those situations that are around your life are pressing you down, would you still press on to pray? When everything around you are literally making prayer to look ineffective in your life, when everything around you make it look as if your worship unto God has been a waste, would you still press on? Would you still give your longing to God? Would you still say, "Whatever the case is, I will touch you, Lord. Whatever the case is, you would hear my cry in heaven. Whatever the case is, my voice of intercessions will be heard. Whatever the situation is, you will still receive my offerings of praise. Whatever the problem is, you will still hear me call your name and say you are the faithful God." David will say, "I will follow hard after you. Nevertheless, whatever the case is, my life may be in danger at this point. I may be chased back and forth, but I will not stop praising you. I may be running for my life, but I will not stop worshiping you." And the word of God recorded 3 times a day he would worship, he would pray. 7 times he would give God that adoration that is deserving unto him. He made up his mind to follow hard after God. Despite the situations he was faced with, he made up his mind that "I will get to give my God the honor and the praise that he deserves. The honor and the praise that is due unto him." This was the mindset of this woman. She made up her mind to go in the press. She made up her mind to go with the Lord. She made up her mind that all of these years that has been a setback to me, I will not let it stop me until I've touched my master. Are you telling yourself today that whatever the situation is, I will do all to touch my master? I will do all to pursue him wherever he is. I will do all to follow hard after him. When prayer seemed to look very ineffective, when it seemed as if all of the worship, all of the things I'm doing in service unto God is not seen, when it seemed as if the things I'm giving to God has nothing to show for it, has nothing at all to show for it, I would maintain my life of worship unto God. I would maintain my pressing on unto him. I will keep following him so hard until he changes my story. I will keep following him so hard until he will show up. And if he decides not to show up, my God, I will still love him. If he decides not to show up, I will still keep to my salvation. If he decides not to show up, I will still call him my Lord and my God. It takes a great faith to say such words. It is never easy to say. Sometimes it may be easy to say, but to live in it out may be more demanding. But if you make up your mind and say, "Whatever the case is, these problems may have lingered for so long, but I'll be with my God. I'll hold on to my God until I have received all that is in his hands." And I want to assure you, you shall receive all that is in his hands, and you shall have a cause to testify in the name of Jesus. It is well with you, beloved. God bless you, and Shalom.